नैनो पार्टिकल्स आर एक्सट्रीमली स्मॉल इन साइज एंड ऑप्टिकल माइक्रोस्कोप्स आर नॉट यूजफुल टू व्यू देम. वी विल हैव टू गो फॉर वेरी हाई रिजॉल्विंग पावर माइक्रोस्कोप्स सच एज स्कैनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप, ट्रांसमिशन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप, एटॉमिक फोर्स माइक्रोस्कोप. लेट अस डिस्कस सम ऑफ द प्री रिक्विजिट्स रिक्वायर्ड टू अंडरस्टैंड इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप्स. वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग फिनोमिना लाइक इलेक्ट्रॉन स्कैटरिंग, टनलिंग इफेक्ट, इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोकसिंग एंड मैग्नेटोस्टैटिक फोकसिंग. दिस फिनोमिना विल बी यूज इन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप्स. इलेक्ट्रॉन स्कैटरिंग. इलेक्ट्रॉन स्कैटरिंग यूजली इम्प्लाइज दैट द इलेक्ट्रॉन चेंजिंग द पाथ आफ्टर हिटिंग सम अदर स्मॉल पार्टिकल लाइक न्यूक्लियस ऑफ एन एटम और अनदर इलेक्ट्रॉन. एज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स कम वेरी क्लोज टू अदर पार्टिकल्स, देयर मासेस एंड ऑल देयर रिलेटेड फील्ड्स इंटरैक्ट ऑन अ क्वांटम लेवल एंड ड्यू टू दिस डेविएशन अकर्स इन द पाथ ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन. दिस डेविएशन इज कॉल्ड एज इलेक्ट्रॉन स्कैटरिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लेट अस कंसिडर हाई स्पीड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स पेनेट्रेटिंग इन टू द एटम. These high-speed electrons are attracted by the positively charged nucleus and due to this they deviate from their original path. This is equivalent to collision with the nucleus and in this process electrons slow down and lose their energy. So in short, scattering means change in path of the electrons after colliding with some other small particles like nucleus of an atom or another electron. Now to understand tunneling effect, let us consider an insulating layer sandwiched between the two metal layers. Now because there is an insulating layer in between, electrons cannot pass from one metal layer to the other metal layer. But interesting thing is observed when we reduce the width of this insulating layer to 10 to 20 angstroms. So when the width of the insulating layer is very small, of the order of 10 angstroms to 20 angstroms, electrons can pass through this barrier and can come from one metal side to the other metal side. This happens due to a quantum effect and this effect is called as the tunneling effect. So whenever the width of insulating layer between the two metal layers becomes very very small, of the order of 10 to 20 angstroms, electrons can cross that barrier and come on the other side. Electrostatic lenses use the principle of electrostatic focusing for their working. According to this electrostatic focusing principle, a beam of electrons experience a change in direction of a motion when traveled through a non-uniform electric field. This non-uniform electric field can be obtained with the help of two coaxial tubes, metal tubes T1 and T2. So these two tubes T1 and T2 are kept in front of each other with a small gap between them. These are hollow tubes. Potential V1 is maintained on one tube, potential V2 is maintained on the other tube. So due to this, a non-uniform electric field is produced in the gap between the two tubes as a result of different potential applied to the tubes. These are the equipotential surfaces which are perpendicular to electric field lines everywhere. So these equipotential surfaces will separate the two potential regions. For example, if you consider this equipotential surface, on this side of the surface the potential will be smaller than the potential on the other side of this surface. Because as we go in the forward direction, potential is increasing. On the metal tube T2, we are having potential V2 which is greater than V1. Now we know when the light ray enters from one medium to the other medium having different density, it changes the direction. Similarly here, electron beam will change the direction when it enters from one potential region to the other potential region. And as Snell's law in optics, sin I upon sin R equal to mu 2 upon mu 1, this Bethe's law in electron optics, that is states sin I upon sin R equal to square root of V2 upon V1 will be followed. So now when electron beams enter in this region of non-uniform electric field, these electron beams are focused, are brought to a point which is called as the focal point. This happens due to the change in direction of electron beam continuously due to the electric force acting on them as they travel through this non-uniform electric field. And ultimately, this after changing the path continuously, the electron beams will arrive at a single point which is called at the focal point. So, this is called as electrostatic focusing, which is used in electrostatic lenses. So, we can use this type of electrostatic lenses in the electron microscopes. Another type of lenses used in electron microscopes are magnetic lenses. These magnetic lenses use the principle of magnetostatic focusing. In magnetostatic focusing, we use magnetic field to focus the electrons into a small region. When the electrons enter into a magnetic field, then they travel a helical path. Helical path is a combination of circular motion and linear motion. Radius of this helical path is given by mv sin theta upon eb, where m is mass of the electron, v is velocity with which the electron is traveling, theta is the angle at which the electron is entering into the magnetic field, e is charge on the electron, and b is magnetic induction. In magnetostatic focusing, in order to focus the electrons into a small region, what is done is strength of this magnetic field is increased as we go in the forward direction. So, as the strength of the magnetic field is increased as we go in the forward direction, as B increases, R will reduce, and as R reduces, the electrons are brought to smaller and smaller region, and ultimately they will be confined to a very small region. So, this is how focusing of electrons is achieved with the help of magnetic field. It is called as magnetostatic focusing and it is used in magnetic lenses. So, we can use either electrostatic lenses or magnetostatic lenses in the electron microscopes. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to the channel so that you will get timely intimation of new videos uploaded to the channel. Thank you very much.